Hello, I'm here for round three on the draw. I have quite a nice hand. Hopefully, I draw a red source or a different three drop I can play, but it's looking pretty good to me. So, at a minimum, if I can't play the Brazen Scourge, I'll be able to play the mechanic on turn three. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and play Fanatic and attack. My opponent would like to race back. It's unfortunate that I did not draw a red land there. I would have very much liked to. Gonna play the mechanic, return nothing. My opponent has every turn made 2 energy. Not bad. Okay, I did consider staying back to double block, but thought it wasn't worth it. Riparian Tiger. That is quite large. My opponent has certainly enough energy. I'm only playing 4 planes in my deck. Happen to draw all of them. If my opponent attacks with a tiger, I'm gonna triple block. Cross my fingers. Hope that nothing bad happens to me. Do 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 do. Okay, well that wasn't good. If I had waited one turn, I could have got the Wayward Giant into play, but my opponent has a tapper into play, so I would likely just die to damage. Key to the City is not great when you're on the defensive. I could theoretically win this game, even though I got blown out a little bit, because my opponent hasn't done much the past turn and this turn yet. And they are running out of energy. Okay, I'll just go to 3. Hopefully I draw something decent. All right, that's not bad. Okay, assuming that my opponent has nothing, I can afford to attack with Bomet Courier. I get to block the Tiger with the Giant, the John G with the Scourge, and go to 1. So I think I will do that. And I'll just make it unblockable with the key. That way I can start drawing some more cards. My opponent has anything I lose, but it's been that way for a while. Harnessed Lightning. Alright, I have been beaten. Okay, against this opponent, looks like they have a pretty high quality deck. Could board in the pressure point or the hijack. They had a decent amount of removal, Welding Sparks and Harness Lightning, so it's good to keep that in mind. And I certainly don't want Inspired Charge. Alright, I think maybe on the draw I'll bring in pressure point, but on the play I'll just stay nice and aggressive. Alright, this is looking good to me. Unfortunately, I can't get the Blooming Marsh into my first three lands because I need white and double red. So it's going to be tapped. Alright, hopefully I draw a few spells and my opponent has a bit of an awkward draw and then I win. Well, I'm not close to casting this Insidious Will. It's nice that I drew a mountain, now I sort of have one blue source towards the will. High Spire Artisan. Ooh, and my opponent missed a land drop. Does getting the Reservoir into play do me any good? Not really, it's just going to gain me one life every turn. Just going to smash that. So this is definitely tricky, but I'm going to play the Aether Hub. In case I draw Island, I want to be able to play Insidious Will next turn. It's bad if I draw Wayward Giant, but I have more islands than I have Wayward Giants. Otherwise, obviously, it's good to play your tap lands when you're not using your mana. Alright, looks like my opponent just did nothing. Just gonna attack, no need to cast the sparks yet. And I guess I'll play the Reservoir. Pad my life total a little bit. It also gets an artifact into play. This is so nice. Now I can actually kill the Puma Outrider because I have Reservoir. And the Ibex gives me my second energy, so I can use Aether Hub multiple times. So everything's working well. Okay. If I attack with both, my opponent can eat this, chump, or block and trade. I think I'm okay with either. Ooh, they could also double block the Scourge and just take two. It's not too good for me, but I am definitely fine trading the Servant for the Mechanic. Alright, I have evaluated everything. I think attacking is best. In case my opponent has something like Attune with Aether. I really hope I draw either an island or a spell. Both would be good. I mean, obviously not both. Both not gonna happen, but either would be good. This is strange. My opponent just did nothing. Well, I guess I'm gonna attack. Something bad might happen to me, but. Maybe a bounce spell? Wow. Playing the reservoir got my opponent a target for the appetite. Well, it serviced me well enough, gained me 2 life, and let me kill the Pima Outrider. If that was my opponent's best play, then they need to draw something to not be dead again. Right, I'm gonna board and pressure point on the draw to be good against the tiger. And what can I board out? A lot of things I could board out. Don't want to board out creatures against somebody with so much removal. Could board out a land. Definitely risky. Or I could board out tactics or build to smash. I think I'll just switch the tactics for the pressure point, because I'm more likely to be defensive on the draw. I still like build to smash though. It's easy to turn that into a removal spell. This hand is not good, but it's good enough. Okay, well, I hope I draw either Aviary Mechanic or land. Pressure point I could also use to cycle. I have a few decent draws. Q-Jar Seed Sculptor, that's pretty strong. Alright, I did draw a mountain, so I got part of what I wished for. It's pretty rough being on the draw in this format. There's so many cards that are just better on the play. All the thriving creatures, this infiltrator I have. Alright, nice. My opponent took the turn off. Think that I should just play the Scourge. It's much better than the Infiltrator. And I have Ibex to replenish my energy if I want to at some point cast the Insidious Will. I also only have 2 islands, so it's not that likely to come up. If I had an island in my hand, maybe I would just play the Infiltrator. All right, my opponent and I are just racing back and forth. Here's a wild wanderer. Don't really feel like trading for that, so I'll just play my Ibex. I could have cast Madcap Experiment, but certainly not worth it. I might just hit a Bomat Courier and take 10 damage. Glimmer of Genius. That card is pretty good, but I'm glad that my opponent played a card draw spell instead of a big creature. Maybe they have Harness Lightning. Alright, I think I'm just gonna attack with both, so that if I attack with just the goat, then my opponent could double block this way. I get in some damage, and then I'll just play an infiltrator. If my opponent gets up to some shenanigans, then I have welding sparks. Don't like this, but I am gonna take it. Be nice if I had my mana up when my opponent played that, then I could Welding Sparks it with the trigger on the stack. My opponent still has three cards in hand. That is many. I could attack with the Ibex. It's pretty bad if my opponent just takes it though. If they block with a Puma Outrider, then I would be happy. This Blooming Marsh also terrible, because otherwise I would have been able to play the Wayward Giant. My opponent is getting aggressive. But that's fine with me. Wow, Gear Seeker Serpent. Can't really beat that. Yeah, I don't think I can win. Well played. This is fishy. But I have basically no removal in my deck. So even though my opponent likely has a trick, I think that I should just block. Yeah, I think that this is my best chance to win, even though it's very likely my opponent has something. Okay, they didn't have anything. Pretty weird. Very weird, in fact. If my opponent just made unblockable or didn't attack, they would be better off. And they're down to one card. I have two cards. Not like they're gonna do much. Insidious Will is a really good card if you can cast it. Makes you feel very safe. Wow, no attacks. Okay, well, I could cast the experiment, hope to get an artifact. Nope, not gonna do that. No, I'll just pass, pretend like it. I mean, I have perfect mana and three cards in hand, so. Must be kind of scary for my opponent. I'm also missing land drops while my opponent has 10 lands. I guess I should play this mechanic. I should have tapped the Aether Hub, that was a mistake, so I should be have one more mana up. Was a very minor mistake. If I draw an island, I'm in decent shape. Fateful Showdown. Alright, let's just cast that. Cast that bad boy. Oh, never mind. I only have I have four cards in hand right now, but I would go down to three, so I need to wait one turn. I almost made a boo-boo. Ooh, the Sky Whale. I can kill that, though. That's more threatening anyway. I am losing out on a lot of my premium rares, though. Oh, and I just got three lands. That's rough. The Insidious Will was actually pretty good if I ever drew an island, as was the Metallurgic Summonings. Wonder what I can draw at this point. Well, Windrake might beat me all by itself. If I have another mechanic in my deck and draw it, that would be good. I probably shouldn't have played the Reservoir though, because if I draw a spell next turn, I can play the Reservoir first and then the spell. That way I gain a bit of life. Right, this is my first attempt at blocking. Looks good to me. Won't take any damage. I could block slightly differently. I think that this is best. My opponent had Welding Sparks. Pretty rough. And I drew nothing. If I had Insidious Will for Welding Sparks, that'd be quite good. All right, thank you for watching.